Once again, in order to solve an exponential equation, we have to make sure what? The base on each side must be the same, right? So let's look at this question here. On the left side, we have base of 3. On the right side, we have this ugly thingy, okay? So guys, what do we have to do? We have to somehow do everything we can to convert this whole ugly thing to base of 3, right? Okay, so let's do that. So we have 3. Okay, now. Guys, 81. Let's convert that to base of 3. In fact, we know 81 is 3 to the power of 4, right? That's a pretty easy one. Next. Guys, how about this guy right here? We have a fifth root. We have a fifth root. And inside is fifth root of 729. Okay, guys, 729. Not as obvious. Okay, guys, are we able to convert this to base of 3? Let's see. So divide by 3, we get 2, 4, 3. Divide by 3, 81. Divide by 3, 27. Divide by 3, 9. Divide by 3, 3. Oh, nice. So 729, we can write that as 3 to the power of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 of them. Okay? So 729 is 3 to the power of 6. Ah. Okay. Now, next. So we're not going to touch anything on the left side. We still have x over 4 minus 4 over 5. Now on the right side, right here, guys, this guy right here, fifth root of 3 to the power of 6, are we able to write this as a simple expression, base of 3? Yes, right? We can do it this way, remember? The rational exponent rule, this guy right here. The rational exponent rule tells us that this guy, we can write it as 6 on top, 6 stays on top at the exponent, divided by 5 on the bottom. So 5 goes to the bottom at the denominator, right? Yeah, according to the rational exponent rule, right? Look, 6 on top, 5 on the bottom. 6 on top divided by 5 on the bottom, right? Mm-hmm. Next. So guys, once again, we don't have to change anything on the left side. Guys, why? Because the left side is already nice by itself, right? It's already base of 3. So we're not going to do anything to it. But on the right side, now we have two numbers. Base of 3 times base of 3. Guys, multiply. So we have to apply what? The multiplication law, right? Mm-hmm. So, now, base of 3 times base of 3, when we combine them together, what do we do with the exponent? We add them up. So we have 4 add up the second exponent, 6 over 5. You see that, guys? So going from here to here, we are just applying the multiplication law, right? Mm-hmm. Good. So now next. Guys, base of 3, base of 3. Nice. Guys, this is what we're trying to achieve, right? All the way along. Okay, and now we are here. Base of 3, base of 3. So for the inequality to hold, we know what? Exponent must equal exponent, right? So now we know that So we know that exponent on the left, which is x over 4 minus 4 over 5, must equal the exponent on the right side, which is 4 plus 6 over 5, right? Okay, let's clear out some space. Okay, so guys, let's try to solve for x right now. So this is very simple algebra. Guys, so to solve for x, well, we have denominator here, right? So guys, why don't we multiply everybody by the common denominator? So guys, here we have three denominator, 4, 5, and 5. Well, guys, what's the common denominator for 4 and 5? 20, right? So multiply everybody by the common denominator, which is 20. Okay? So guys, look. So guys, multiply 20 in. So guys, 20 divided by 4, we have 5. So we have 5x. You see that? 20 divided by 4, we have 5. So 5x. Minus 20 divided by 5, we have what? 4. And 4 times 4 is 16. You see that? Yeah. So 20 times 4 is 80. Now, here. 20 times the last number. So guys, look. 20 divided by 5, we have 4. Right? And 4, we must multiply by 6 at the numerator. So we have 24. Nice? Yep. So now we can solve this. So 5x equals to, guys, 80 plus 24. And then, guys, let's move the negative 16 to the other side. Becomes positive 16. So at the end, 5x equal 24 plus 16, we get 40, right? 40 plus 80, we get 120. Okay, so at the end, divided by 5, divided by 5, 5 cancels, x equal 120 divided by 5, we get 24. There we go, that's the answer.